So neuroplasticity and adhesions, let's take a look at that. We end up with increased neuronal density. We talked about that, how we have those increase in neurons, increased inflammatory mediators, the cytokines that get produced, decreased viscoelasticity in the serous fluid space, increased adhesions in the various layers of the fascia. This is in this picture that you're looking at right here, this is a picture of the liver, and you're seeing adhesions between the visceral peritoneum and the parietal peritoneum. Those are not supposed to be there. So when they're there, you can imagine what that's going to feel like in your hand, and that's what we do, right? We're manual therapists. So we feel things with our hands, and you can feel this. You can feel a decrease in viscoelasticity, an increase in the fibrosity of the tissues, a decreased motion of the organ. If this is sitting like this and it's stuck to the parietal peritoneum, then it's clearly not moving very well. Decreased function of the organ. As Jean-Pierre says, an organ with good motion has physiologic function. So if it can't move, it can't function. It's not going to function as well. So in this videographic study that was done in 1985 by Finney and William, they conducted a radiographic and echographic study of visceral motion relative to the motion of the diaphragm with breathing. So I'm going to show you some of the videos from that study that were done. Here's a video of the stomach just to orient you. This is the stomach filled with a contrast medium. This is the duodenum. Notice that beautiful glide and that slide that's happening with breath. The stomach and the duodenum are going in a superior position and then inferior with breath. This is something that's not so functional. I think the person is still breathing, but here's the stomach. You can see the contrast medium too. It's pretty much stuck in the pyloric antrum of the stomach and in the duodenum. There's no slide and glide. No slide and glide. I think I'd rather have the one that was before this. This is really fascinating. This is an image. You're going to see a drawing of it showing you the borders. Notice this is the liver. This is before treatment. And then you're going to see the actual image, which I think is even more impressive. You can see this really hesitant motion of the liver with breath. Then a manual therapist comes along and decides to mobilize the liver a little bit, and this is what happens. Big motion, big motion. Nice big slide. If an organ can move, it can function. And I'm going to share with you a case that I've actually seen this with in my own practice that's really impressive. Here's a stomach. This is the fundus of the stomach, the pyloric antrum filled with contrast. This is the spine back here. So really hesitant, ratchety kind of motion up and down. They're breathing. The stomach has that hesitant motion. Here's after treatment. Nice, big, slow, rhythmic glide, superior and inferior. So this is a case that I've been working with. She's a 52-year-old woman. Her chief complaint is long-term severe gastroesophageal reflux disease with gallbladder pain and fatty liver disease. Here's a fatty liver. Here's a normal liver. There's a lot of little fat globules around the hepatocytes in here. This is going to decrease motion of the liver. She's had blood labs done, her ALT and AST. Those are two enzymes that are produced by the liver. They shouldn't be any higher than 40, 45 for ALT, 40 for AST. And personally, in my own practice, I don't like to see them above 20. 20, 15 to 20 is really a really healthy level. She also had a gallbladder ejection fraction done. Gallbladder ejection fraction is where they do a HIDA scan while they have a radioactive dye that's been injected, and then they give them a little bolus of an injected bolus of cholecystokinin. Cholecystokinin stimulates the gallbladder to contract, and then they take a measurement of the gallbladder before the contraction and after the contraction. And this shouldn't be any lower than about 27%. Her ejection fraction was zero. They did some scans. You can see that her ALT was at 302. Her AST was at 77. They did some scans. They did a liver biopsy. They could not figure out where her elevated liver enzymes were coming from. There was no pathological reason for it. This had been going on for some time, at least a couple years. She comes to see me. She had three treatments. I mobilized her liver, her gallbladder, and the common bile duct. So she had a restriction in her liver, obviously, because of the fatty liver disease. It's quite immobile. Gallbladder and the common bile duct. She had a lot of tension around the cystic duct, which I thought was interesting. ALT and AST returned to normal after three treatments, returned to 22 units per liter.